Once upon a time, there lived a honest and kind-hearted old couple with their pet dog in a village. They loved their dog very much. They fed their dog with fish, cookies, and a variety of food. One day, the old couple were walking in their garden. All of a sudden, the dog stopped at a place and started barking violently. The old man was puzzled. He thought that there should be something underneath for the dog to eat. So they started digging the ground. After digging for a while, he was amazed. What did he see? They saw gold pieces, silver pieces, and all sort of precious things buried there. The couple were glad. Being a kind-hearted couple, they gave alms to the poor and needy. Even after giving alms to many, they were left with a huge sum of money. With it, they bought corn fields, paddy fields, and everything they needed. The three were more happy now. Contrastingly, in the neighboring house, there lived a greedy and stingy old couple. They came to know about the treasure. So, the greedy old man went to his neighbor and borrowed his dog. He brought the dog to his house. They prepared a great feast for him. They pleaded the dog to show the place where plenty of money is there. But the dog had received only ill treatment from his neighbor till the day before. So it refused to eat. He lost his patience and dragged the dog to his garden. The dog didn't even utter a word, but when forced, it went to a place and started sniffing the ground. Thinking that it is a lucky spot, the old man started digging the ground greedily, but they found only a quantity of dirt and nasty offal there. They had to hold their noses. They both got angry. So they thrashed the dog and killed it. They dug a pit under a pine tree and buried it. The kind-hearted old couple were wondering why their dog was not returned to them. He went to his neighbor and asked him the whereabouts of his dog. The neighbor told him that he had killed the dog and buried it under the pine tree. The good old man was heartbroken. He shed tears, grieving his dog's loss. He went to the spot and set out a tray with food. He burnt incense sticks and adorned the grave with flowers. That night, when the couple were fast asleep, the dog appeared in their dream. The dog told the old man to cut the pine tree under which it was buried and asked him to make a mortar out of it. It told the old man to use the mortar, thinking of it as if it were himself. The good old man woke up from his dream. He did as told by his pet dog. A new mortar was ready. They ground some rice using the mortar. But to their astonishment, each grain of the rice turned into some rich treasure. The wicked couple heard of this too. The wicked old man went straight to his neighbor's house and borrowed the mortar too. They too started grinding some rice. But the mortar didn't give them treasure. It only turned all the rice into filth. The wicked couple got angry, and in that anger, they broke the mortar. They burnt it too. Again, the dog appeared in the good man's dream. It told his owner what had happened. The dog told its lovable master to collect all the ashes of the burnt mortar. It told him that if the ashes were sprinkled on a withered tree, the withered tree would turn into a beautiful new tree with full of flowers and leaves. The old man ran out weeping to his neighbor's house, pleaded him, and got back his ashes. He made a trial on a withered cherry tree and found the cherry tree sprouting and blooming instantly after he sprinkled the ashes on it. The old man put the ashes into a basket. He roamed all over the country, announcing him as a man with superpowers. The news reached a prince, and he summoned the old man to his court. He asked the old man to perform his magic tricks before him. The old man took some ashes and sprinkled it on a withered tree. To their amazement, the withered tree started growing new leaves and flowers all over its trunk and branches. The prince felt extremely happy. He rewarded the old man with rich presents. The wicked old man heard this news too. He went to the place where he had burned the mortar and collected all the remaining ashes. He too put all the ashes in a basket and started walking straight to the prince's court to prove his majestic strength. Without being summoned, he met the prince and told him that he too has supreme powers, and if given a chance, he can exhibit it. In front of the prince and his soldiers, the wicked old man took a handful of ashes and sprinkled it on some withered trees. But oh, nothing happened. The withered trees stood as it was. But the sprinkled ashes flew into the air and filled the prince's eyes and choked his mouth too. When the soldiers saw this, they beat him almost to death. The wicked old man crawled off home in a very sorry plight. Hearing this, the good old man scolded his neighbor for his greediness. After scolding them, he gave them a share of their own riches. On receiving such a gesture from their neighbors, the greedy couple too mended their ways and led a good and virtuous life thereafter.